Hello, Diamond Painting Addicts, and welcome back to Diamond Painting Anonymous. I'm Daphne, and I'm here today with kind of an unusual video for me. So, as many of you know, I have been working on my Wolf Shaman for my DP for Pets 2023 event. I think this video will come out pretty close to the end of the event, or maybe right after. I don't know how long it's going to take me to edit. This is a new venture for me. I asked in a whip and chat if you guys would be interested in seeing it. Because both the unboxing and the kit up I have filmed a while ago, obviously. And so many of the things that I talk about in that I may have repeated in whip-in chats because I had sort of decided just to skip the unboxing and the kit up and not share those videos because the event was drawing to a close, et cetera, et cetera. But many of you seemed very excited about the prospect of seeing the kit from beginning to end. So here is that video. I am finished, as you can see, and I'm getting ready to kit down. I don't know how much of the kit down will make it into the video. I will kind of smush everything together for you so you can see it. And I'm probably going to cut down the videos, both the unboxing and the kitting up, just because this video is already going to be very long. And so, yeah, I'm just going to cut some stuff down. And hopefully, I can manage to cut out anything that might be a repeat. If not, I apologize in advance for repeating things that you've heard already. But like I said, these got filmed a few weeks ago and you guys seem interested in this. So here it is. First, you're going to see the unboxing, then you'll see the kit up, and then I will be back if I'm not done kitting down to finish kitting down, share with you my thoughts, my changes, all that good stuff. And then we'll take a trip out to the living room or the dining room to look at the finished kit. I will do some B-roll so that you guys can see it, you know, kind of close up. And I've got several pictures of it full on, straight on, so that you guys can see that as well. Because I know filming in the dining room tends to leave it at a weird angle. But yeah, it's the only place I have that really is large enough to film something like that. And I don't have a good overhead setup for out in the living room, in the dining room. So sorry about that, but it is what it is. Okay. I'm super excited about this kit, so I can't wait to show you the guys the finish of it. But first, the unboxing and the kit up. See you in a bit. So this one sadly is no longer available, but it is called Wolf Shaman by Dean Russo. It is a square and it is 22 by 28 inches, which is 56 by 71. I'm going to get everything out of the box and we'll get started. All right, this is an older kit, so we'll look at the toolkit in just a minute. But like I said, it is Wolf Shaman by Dean Russo. It is so nice and colorful. Actually thought it was a round, just now realizing, but it's a square, so it's all good. All right, let's look in our toolkit and see what we get in our toolkit. Lots of goodies in here. All right, we get a standard tray. We get two plates of wax, heart-shaped wax. We get a blue pin with a scrunchie and a four-placer. Not gonna lie, the four-placers are my favorite. We get some very sharp pokey tweezers, also one of my favorite tools. And then we get a bunch of baggies. Now, let's see what the actual kit looks like. And let's see what else we've got here. We've got our instructions. I won't use those. We've got our pre-cut stickers. We've got 49 colors. And then we've got our larger image here of the actual canvas. And I'm hoping maybe my daughter will want this one. She's super into wolves and it's really colorful and very shamanic. That seems right up her alley. But I've thought that before, so who knows? It looks like we get four ABs in here, maybe? So we'll be looking for that. 49 colors. Here are all of our drills. You can see nice and bright and colorful. I can see one of the ABs there. All right, let me go grab the canvas and I will be right back. Canvas, here's the top half of the canvas. And we just have this very colorful shamanic looking wolf. I like it. It's almost mandala-like with all of the different colors and everything. Just super colorful. So I can't wait. I think there's going to be some nice multi-placing, obviously, here and in some of the background, and then a lot of confetti in here. We'll see what happens. So we've got 49 colors. We've got our schematic on both sides, as always with Diamond Art Club. DMC codes, everything looks good. Now, this is 22 by 28 inches or 56 by 71 centimeters. Let me grab my measuring tape. All right, so 56, it is 55 across, so not quite 56, but it is, and it's 21 3/4 inches, so not quite 22. And there you can see a little bit more, oh, almost the whole thing fits on. You can see kind of this background colors, the pinks and the blues and the yellows. Just a very colorful, and yeah, really looking forward to see what this one looks like. All right, it is 27 1/2 inches, so not 28 for the drill field, and that is 70 centimeters, not 71. I'm not going to stretch that a whole nother centimeter. So pretty close, 70 and 27 1/2 by, what did I say? It wasn't 20 across. It was like 21 something, wasn't it? 21 3/4 and 55 across. So pretty close. 56 by 71 is what they have listed. It's 55 by 70 by my measurements on the drill field. I'm really looking forward to this one. I actually thought it was a round, so I thought it would go faster. It is a square, so it's going to take me a bit longer, but I'm still excited about it. I don't know if I'll get it finished before the end of DP for Pets, but I'll try. All right, it is Diamond Art Club, so of course it is nice and sticky where you need it to be. I'm not going to be worried about any of the symbols. There is quite a bit of black because everything is outlined in black, but I think I will approach this as I did with my Elizabeth, and I will do a lot of the outlining and stuff first and then go and fill in. Also, I may do some of the background first and then concentrate on the wolf. I don't know, we'll see. I really like the eyes here. I think those are going to be super pretty. I may have to go dig through my drills and see if there are any additional ABs I can add. But let's go through the drills and see what ABs we have first. We've got some very dark blue, some kind of reddish dark brown, a pink, kind of a pale turquoise green, a light purple, a butterscotch, like a berry magenta, kind of a peachy orange, a light green, and a true green. We've got like kind of a brownish peach, another green, a blue, a purple, and then a light purple, kind of a darker sea green turquoise, a very pale peach, a pink, a peach, and a dark purple. We've got a spring green, kind of a dark purple, kind of a cornflower blue, a light green, a dark green, a very dark blue, a green, a dark pink, kind of a turquoise blue, another green. Oh, there's one of our ABs. That is kind of a yellowish orange AB. And then we've got some pink shades here. We've got like a dusky pink, a very kind of magenta mulberry color, a watermelon pink, a very bright peach. Ooh, two bags of this blue AB. That's very pretty. Purple, and then two bags of this dark blue turquoise. We've got another like lavender, ooh, some very pretty dark purple ABs, two bags of white, two bags of another dark purple, a gray, another kind of bubblegum color, ooh, another pretty pink AB, two bags of bright yellow, a green, and then we've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 bags of black and kind of a sky blue. I can't wait. It's very nice and bright and colorful. Yeah, how many did I say? 49 colors. Okay, and we had how many ABs? So we've got this pink AB, which is the number one, and that goes where? There's some here in the wolf, some up here at this piece in the top, some in the background up here. So just kind of some down here sprinkled in all over. So that's one AB. And then we've got this dark purple AB, which is the number two. There's some right here sprinkled in here. Do I see any in the background? Yeah, sprinkled down here at the bottom on this corner. There's some of that color. And then our orange here, orange-yellow, I guess, is number three. And it also is sprinkled around the face of the wolf here, just kind of here, there, and everywhere. For the last AB, we've got two bags full of this blue, which is number four, and it is sprinkled all through the bottom on this side in the background, also on this side on the background. Trying to see, yeah, there's a few places here on the wolf, but most of that blue is in the background. So definitely gonna see, I'm pretty sure I have some 209 or 210 ABs that I can add in. I don't think I'm gonna use any black ABs. I think I want the black to fade into the background and just be the shadows, and that doesn't happen with the black ABs. Okay guys, there you go. There is the Wolf Shaman by Dean Russo from Diamond Art Club. And I'm here today with the kit up of my Wolf Shaman by Dean Russo from Diamond Art Club. So you can see the artwork here. I've got my stickers. I'm going to be kitting this up into one of my Elizabeth Ward cases. Okay, so first things first. The color that I have the most of is 310. So I'm going to mark one of these as 310. I have my largest size container for Elizabeth Ward. I've got, like I said, six bags. I'm really excited to do this kit. I think I mentioned before, or if I didn't, I originally had planned to do a different kit. I originally had intended to do a different kit. However, I wasn't really thrilled with that kit. I was doing it because I felt I should and not because I wanted to. And I told myself that this year, this would be a year where I worked on kits because I wanted to and not because I felt I had to. I spent a lot of time last year working on things because I thought I should, and I spent a lot of my diamond painting time miserable because I was working on kits that I didn't particularly like. It's not that I didn't like the kits, it's just, you know, sometimes you're feeling a particular kit, sometimes you're not, and you'd rather work on something else. This kit has been sitting for quite a while. It is one, well, I bought it long enough ago. I don't know that this matters. I want to say I bought it long enough ago that it's discontinued, but sometimes stuff is discontinued as soon as it comes out, so who knows? And there's my spill. Okay, so I guess I got it out of the way early. Let me try to get these in the tray so I can pick them up, because of course I spilled. Because what would it be? Wouldn't be a kit up if I didn't spill something, right? All right, is that the last one? Did I get them all? Nope, there's one. Okay. All right, let me get these in here, see if I can get these in here without spilling. I might have to, I don't know if I'm gonna get both bags in here. We'll see. Maybe. All right, this is my last bag of 310. Let's see if I can get it in the container without spilling it, and if I can get it all in here. Okay. Oop, one floating on the top. All my 310 in two of these large containers. That actually makes me very happy. All right, what else do I have duplicates of? Because I'm going to stick them in. Instead of the largest containers, I think I'm going to stick them in these because I think they'll fit. Now, one of my ABs I have quite a bit of. I actually have two bags of this AB. There are four ABs in this kit, and I did go through my list of ABs that I have to see if I had anything I wanted to pull out to use in this kit. And I did find two ABs. I'm going to be using some additional 210 ABs and some additional 550. Now, 550, there's not a ton of drills in this kit, so I'll probably just replace all the drills with ABs. Most of the time when I add in ABs, I just kind of randomly insert the ABs, like whatever color they are. So for instance, if I had a lot of 550, I would just randomly add my 550 ABs. But since, oh, and I didn't, what number was that? 138. I didn't put the sticker on there, you guys. Oh my goodness. That would have been bad. It's a good thing it was an AB, so I knew which one it was. All right, so there's my first AB. Then, what other colors do I have? I've got 307 that I have two bags of. So let me grab another one of this size. See if I can fit both of these in here. I want to wait and see if I can fit them both in here before I put the sticker on. And I can't fit all of that in there. Okay. So let me transfer all of these, hopefully without spilling them everywhere. See, there's only two bags, so you wouldn't think it would be that full, but apparently it was. All right, get out of there. Okay, so let me pour the rest of these in here. And this, and then I will grab my sticker. So I'm just pouring these everywhere today. All right, and this is 307, so let me grab that sticker. So we've got 307, then I've got two bags of 333, and again, they're not very full, so let me try and stick them in here. I'm trying to make sure I keep everything in order so I don't get it all out of order. 333, again, I'm gonna wait to put on the sticker until I see if they all fit in here. They were not quite as full as the 307, so maybe I can get them all in one of these size. And then I think I just have one or two more colors that I've got multiple bags of. Maybe just two. All right, my little trash can is already getting full. All right, let me see if I can get all these in here. I think I'm gonna manage it with this one. Come on, get out of there. All right. Okay, so all of those are in there, and that was 333. Yes, 333. So I can put this one on here. There's that color. Then my next double color is 3844. Again, neither of these bags are super full, so I'm going to try and put them in one this size. Oh, you guys, the weather has been killing me. It's been so hot here lately, hot and humid. My son and I were talking, and I wouldn't have said that where we live is very humid, but apparently if you live somewhere where there's a lot of farming, the crops put off a lot of humidity. And we live somewhere there's a lot of farming, so who knew? I think it was 93% humidity today when we went out for our walk. This color has a bit of static in it. All right, 3844, managed to get all of them in the container. They do have a bit of static, as you can see, sticking to the edge. I need 3865 is the last one I have that has two bags. And it is, neither one of these are very full. So I should be able to get all these in here, no problem. How come white never seems to be very staticky? I wonder if the color of the drills has anything to do with how staticky they get sometimes. Just seems like certain colors are worse than others. All right, then 3865. Goes in there. Okay, I think the rest of them now, I'm just going to be picking out like big bags, and I'm going to save the little bags for the small containers. So what do I have that looks pretty full? Actually, this bag of ABs seems pretty full. So let me put that in here. And like I said, I put them all in DMC order so that they're all sorted and I can make sure as I'm pouring them in that I've kind of got everything together and I'm not missing any bags or anything. But I just don't put them, I don't diamond paint by DMC order. I diamond paint by symbol. So I'll just know I need the number one, and I'll learn, okay, in my tray, the number one is in this spot, and so on and so forth. So that's how I do it. This one does 3846. Some of these seem a little bit too full, like they're not gonna fit in the next size down container. This is 3846. All right, I don't know when you guys are gonna be seeing this because YouTube time is weird. Let's see, 33, 41, and I think this one too are both kind of full. So 33, 41, huh. That used to be my address once upon a time. All right, 33, 41. Isn't that funny how you can remember things and then other things you forget that are more recent? Like, I can tell you my phone numbers from all the houses that I lived in as a kid. We only lived in two houses, but then my parents moved. I still remember their address. Weirdly, I don't remember my addresses once my phone numbers. And then not too long after I got married and moved out, you know, cell phones became a thing and nobody remembers anybody's phone numbers anymore, right? When you teach kids at the preschool how to dial 911, you got to teach them how to do it on a cell phone, because hardly anyone has landlines anymore. Who remembers any numbers, right? You just let your phone remember them. Remember when they made you memorize all the phone numbers? Nobody does that anymore. Okay, I think these two are kind of full. So let me do these. 762. This seems like 762 is one of those colors that's in so many kits all over the place. All right, 762. Okay, there's that one. And then 718. We're trying to decide which one of these. I think 602 has more in. So I'll put this one in here first. Into this one. Because I think this is going to be my last one of this size. And then I'll move down to a smaller size. There's a drill that escaped. All right, what number was this? 602. Okay, now I can move down to this size, I think, and we'll see how far I get with this size before I need to move down to the smallest one. All right, I think I'm gonna do both of the ABs in this size because I don't think they're gonna fit in the smallest one. And then I'll finish with these two. I've got a few more that probably have more than will fit in the teeniest ones. That way I save the teeniest sizes for what I really need them for. All right, which one was this? 131. And the second one is 119. I guess technically this one should go in front of the other one. This is number two and the other one is a three. All right. So all of the ABs have been kitted up now. Then in these small ones, what to call these? They're not the largest. They're not the smallest. There's those two in between sizes and I never know what to call them. Maybe it should be small, medium, like this is the medium, and then large and extra large. Uh-oh, what is this, 601? Started to throw that one in the trash before I put the sticker on. That would have been bad for me. All right, then this one is gonna be 718. Then I will go through and pick some more that are kind of full. All right, 718. With 40 colors, no, how many did I have? 49 colors? Gets to be a lot. I'm gonna do this purple. This bag got kind of sealed at an angle. I always find it funny when I find little idiosyncrasies like that. I pay attention, I think, because I watch too many CSI shows. So I'm like, oh, you could probably match that because it's got the same like marks. And why do you suppose it is that So many diamond painters. Oh no, what was that? 3837? I just stuck it in there and I... 3846, nope, that one was used. 3837, whew! See, I get to talking about stuff and I'm not paying attention. All right, 3837, that sticker is sticking off a little too much. And now it's crooked. You guys, my brain is exhausting some days. Let's see, do I have any more that I think I need to? This one's pretty full. This one's pretty full. This one's pretty full. All right. Let me just keep going here. 954. I'm going to start putting these stickers on first now because I'm going to confuse myself if I don't. The rest of these should all fit in one container. And again, staticky. Only one escapee. That's not too bad. Then 3766. I always wonder why it is that so many, not just diamond painters, but crafters in general, watch crime shows. I don't know why that is. All right, so that one wasn't completely full, but that's okay. I'm still going to use up these medium-sized ones until I get to the very small ones. Yes, it was 3845. All right, let me empty out my little trash can here, and I will be right back. All right, slight change of plans. I've got so many colors left that I'm going to start doing the ones in the small bottles first, or the small containers, just so I can see how many I'm going to need, and then if I can use the rest of the next size up, then I will do that. These will actually go in DMC order as I kit these up. Again, I don't diamond paint in DMC order. I paint by the symbol, so the fact that I'll show you the kit when I get, show you the tray and what it looks like when I get done kitting everything up. All right, then 210. Maybe it'll go faster now that I'm going in order because I won't forget to put the sticker on here. You guys, I was thinking of running a poll on my community tab. I know I asked you guys last time when I was doing the Phoebe and Beauregard mermaid kit which one you guys thought I should do between that and the other mermaid one. I ended up doing both of them, but I did the Phoebe and Beauregard first. But I'm curious, YouTube has made some changes to the way people get monetized, which I think is great. It actually makes it easier for people to get monetized. However, now I'm curious, like what makes you, 336. Do I want to do that one right now? I think I'm going to wait on that one and I'm going to do 340 first. What makes you watch diamond painters? Like, are the popular diamond painters popular because, is it personality? Is it, you know, their lifestyle or what they talk about? Because, you know, everybody has their own style of things. I mean, I'm sure we all talk about our lives, but everybody's life is different. And so is it something like that? Is it strictly, I guess not strictly, but is it more what they unbox? Is it they give you more tips and tricks? Is it that they stay on top of, I don't know, what's going on in diamond painting? I guess not just diamond painting, but diamond painting and crafting, because there's a lot of that that kind of overlaps too. Anyway, I'm just really curious. I mean, I don't think anybody, I think the biggest YouTube diamond painters are big because they do other crafts besides just diamond painting. I think diamond painting is enough of a niche that nobody's going to have a million subscribers on their diamond painting channel. There just aren't that many diamond painters. If it's a crafting channel, then, you know, you can include all sorts of other things like crochet, like knitting, like paint by number, like resin work, like, I don't know, the million and one other things that people do for crafts. But I'm just really curious, you know, what, like, if you have a YouTuber that every time they publish a video, you watch it, why? What is it about that YouTuber that makes you do that? Just curious. And if you don't have an answer, that's no big deal too. But I think, I don't know, would anybody, maybe that's just my curiosity. My sister told me once I should just be a perpetual student, which honestly didn't sound terrible. If I had money to just be a perpetual student, I probably would. I like learning things. Is that wrong? I want to learn stuff. I want to learn new things. What's wrong with that? All right, come on, get out of there. Or go flying across the table. That works too. I do have quite a few of these that are going to fit in these very teeny tiny containers. Let's see if I run out before I run out of colors. I don't know if you guys can hear it. I hope you can't. It's summer, so it's construction season, right? The street, one street over from us, they have torn out like two city blocks where they are redoing, like they ripped it clean out to bare dirt and are putting in an all new street. Which, you know, is nice, but it's been raining so much that it's been, I don't know, over a month now. If I lived on that street, I'd be super annoyed because people can't get out of their driveways because of all the construction and then it being halted because of the rain. 992, 993, 939. There's not a ton of 939 in this kit. That's nice, I guess. Makes up for the. I guess you don't need a lot of 939 when you have six bags of black. But anyway, I don't know how long it's going to take before they get the construction done, because I don't know what that's going to do when we try and sell our house. Although it is such a seller's market right now, I was looking at. We've been looking at property in other towns. And the town where my sister lives, like one house for sale under 100,000, everything else is in the 250 and up range, and most of them were in the 500K range, which is insane to me. It is not a big city and it does not have a lot of amenities. And then I was looking in the town where we live. Currently, there's maybe two properties for sale in the town where we live. Maybe two, maybe three. And you know, most of the houses in the town where we live are pretty old. The big section of town, whoops, is all old houses. I mean, talking built in the some of them in the 1800s. Late 1800s, early like 1920s, 1930s. And then there's a section of town down where we live that is all newer houses that were built in like the 2000s. You know, a property developer came in and built a bunch of houses, but there are no houses for sale except for those two or three. One was an older home and they still wanted 100,000 plus, even though it needs a ton of work. And the other one is not as nice as our house and they're asking 250K for it. So I told my husband, I'm so torn. You know, we'd like to sell our house so that we can use that money to buy something in Canada. But we refinanced our mortgage at just the right time, apparently. And I'm really like reconsidering if we want to hang on to this and just rent it out, because we could definitely rent it out for probably double, maybe triple what our mortgage is. And that would pay all of the expenses and let us hang on to it. So I don't know. We also can't decide whether we want to own or rent up in Canada either. You know, in so many ways, renting would be easier. But I would feel bad throwing away all that money on rent instead of just buying something. Does anybody else ever feel that way, or is it just me? Or should I just be grateful we can afford anything? I mean, I know how hard it is. We're still trying to find some place for my daughter just to rent that she can afford. And it's crazy. Like everything is a pit, or, you know, it's brand new and they want a bazillion dollars to rent it, which is crazy. All right, getting close to the end here. Okay, I've only got one of these left. So we'll put this color in here. And then I guess the rest of these colors will go in the larger containers, but they're not all gonna, I'm gonna have to double stack my tray, which I often do in the Diamond Art Club ones. I could get out another tray, but I won't. I could, but I won't. I know myself, I won't. I'll just double stack them. It's all good. I could have put this in a bottle case, I guess, but I like my Elizabeth Ward. I've actually been thinking that I might get rid of some of my bottle cases. I know I'm going to have to get rid of some stuff before we move, because there's no way I'm taking everything that we have, that I have, to Canada. But I don't want to just junk it either. I have some storage that I'm going to get rid of. I think I'm going to get rid of my dot box storage. I think I have two Harbor Freights left. I'm going to get rid of those. I've got a bunch of 28 slot containers that I'm never going to use. All right, let me just go and double check and make sure I don't have any more of the tiny ones. I'll be right back. All right, I did have more of the tiny ones. So let's see how this goes, because I'm probably going to move it so... Well, I'll just show you, like I said, I'll show you at the end what it's all going to look like. Ooh, this one's kind of full. Are they all going to go in there? Let's see. I'll at least try to do these in order. I still don't think I'm going to have enough. I won't. I've got four colors left, and I only have three small ones. That's okay. I think for the storage that I'm going to keep, it'll be my Elizabeth Ward. I will keep some of my bottle cases, just not all of them. I have too many of them. And I think all but one of those are 60. And then I have one that has way more than that, but I'll keep that one. And then my 28 grid little 1-inch cubies, I will keep those. I love those. But yeah, the Harbor Freight. And then I've got one, a black one that has like 30 slots or 35 slots. And then I've got another one that has, it's small containers that has 35. I'll probably get rid of both of those, because which one feels like it has less? This one does. Down to my last two colors here. Woohoo! And then I'll show you all of the drills in the tray with my overflow. And then I'll show you the extra ABs that I'm going to add in, which is why I don't mind if there's some floating around on top if all of my trays don't fit down in it. I don't ever, when I'm working on a kit, I don't ever close the lid to my Elizabeth Ward anyway, so it's fine with me if there's a little bit extra floating around. It's all good. Extra containers. You'll see what I mean in just a minute. All right, that was my last one. So, let me clean up a bit and I will be right back. Don't go anywhere. Here we have my tray of drills. Look how beautiful this is with all of these colors. So, I've got three extra ones right here that are going to kind of float, which is fine. Once I use up, you know, some of these black, which I'm going to work on the black first, once I use them up, then I can pull that one out and these can set in there. I've got my little sticker for my logbook, and then I have my two additional ABs. I've got my 550 and my 210. So my 210 is over here, 550 is there. Neither one of them have a ton of drills, so I might be able to get away with just substituting those, and then I'll just put those regular colors in my spares. Okay, so you can see here in the container, things are not necessarily in DMC order. So most of these are in DMC order for what they are, but then where I've got more drills, then these are more in DMC order, and those are not exactly either. But like I said, I paint by symbol, and I'll learn as I go. I'll get used to where, so I'll know, you know, of course the black is here, the yellow is in this big container. That's, you know, one of my ABs. This is one of my ABs. The other two ABs are here, and then I'll learn, you know, oh, this color is in this small one. And you just get used to it, so you know where everything is. So even though it's sort of in DMC order, I paint by symbol. So the DMC, you know, when I'm looking, I'm not looking for 550, I'm looking for the K. I'm not looking for 702, I'm looking for this little black triangle. And that's how I diamond paint rather than buy, you know, I need number 24 or I need DMC 718. So there you go, guys. That is my kit up of the Wolf Shulman by Dean Russo from Diamond Art Club. Okay, guys, here we are out in the dining room with the finished Wolf Shulman. And I absolutely love this kit. I think this is one of my favorite kits ever, hands down, that I have done, which is actually surprising to me. When I bought this kit, I liked the image, but I actually bought it with my daughter in mind, thinking, you know, she's very into wolves, she loves color, she's an artist, and I just thought this would be something that was up her alley. However, I've been known to guess wrong before. So I kind of left it in my stash thinking, oh, I'll get to it at some point. And I had it on my list for my artist series, and I also had it on my list as a possible for DP for Pets. Now, I did think it was a round when I got it out. However, I will say, even as a square, it didn't take me nearly as long as I thought. Yes, it was very confetti heavy in the wolf itself, but there was some nice multi-placing in all four corners. So it really didn't take as long as I thought. I think it took me about 48 hours altogether, which when you say it like that doesn't sound like a lot. And it only took me about 2 weeks because I didn't diamond paint all day every day, obviously. So super stoked that I was able to get this finished in time for the end of DP for Pets, because I actually finished it on the 27th of June. So that means that I managed to get 3 kits done for DP for Pets this year, which is awesome. And 2 of them were full drill kits. My doggos, I don't count those as full drill because they were just the little pieces, but the Fiona Dragon in this one, super happy with both of them. Super happy with this one because not only is it one of my favorite kits, but my daughter loved it. She actually asked for it. I did end up, there were 4 ABs included in the kit. So there were some pink, some yellow, some blue, and some purple ABs. And they're all kind of sprinkled around. You can see some here in the background. You can see them here down in this corner. And then of course, sprinkled all through the wolf itself. So let me zoom in a little bit. And you can see there's the orangey yellow AB is here in the wolf. Like I said, the ones down here, the blue, over here in this section, you can see a lot of the blue. There is some purple that I added that wasn't an AB, and there's also a dark purple that I added that wasn't an AB that's down in this corner section as well. So I added 210 and 550 ABs. And then really the only other change that I made, I noticed when I took a picture, and if I can find it, I'll go back and include it and stick it over there so you guys can see it. But I took a picture of his nose once I had gotten kind of that far, and one of these lines was black. All the rest of them were ABs. And when I went to go peel them up to see if I had done it wrong, underneath them, it was the black symbol. So I hadn't done it wrong. It was just charted that way for whatever reason, which I thought was weird. I thought it looked weird. So I pulled off all the black and went back and made everything in his little nose section here, the bridge of his nose, ABs, because I thought it looked better. Other than that, and the addition of my ABs, I didn't make any changes to this. And I think it turned out so well. I didn't add any black ABs in because I thought that would look weird. I wanted, you know, the black to kind of disappear into shadow, and especially with his nose being as big as it was, I think that would have been, it would have looked weird to have black ABs. So I'm glad I didn't put those in there, even though I was tempted. But I really like all the different colors. I like the diamond here in the middle and the kind of the little Southwest, I don't know, Native American pattern that looks like. And the whole wolf itself, like I think I've said that before, reminds me of like a Zentangle pattern. And I just really like it. I really like how it turns out, how it turned out. I think it's super colorful, super pretty, and I can't wait to see how it's gonna look in the frame. I'm actually really happy with my drill work on this one as well. I mean, there are places where it's not perfectly straight, but overall, plus it helps that there are so many colors, that hides a lot of flaws when it's not, you know, huge straight lines or whatever. It's really easy to disguise that all your lines aren't perfectly straight. So that was fun too. Again, I can't say this enough. I honestly wasn't sure that I would like this kit, and I actually had seen another Dean Russo. This is no longer available at Diamond Art Club. It has been discontinued. However, he has been picked up as licensed over at Dreamer Designs. Now, last time I checked, and I'll stick a link to both Diamond Art Club and Dreamer Designs down below, but last time I checked, this kit at Dreamer Designs was out of stock. They do have several other Dean Russo designs. One's a really cute kitten that I would love to have. However, it has been out of stock as well. But they do have it, so you could sign up to get an email and have them, you know, let you know when it gets restocked. No guarantees that it will, but I'm hoping that they do. And I'm really hoping they restock some of those other Dean Russos as well. There's a kitten, there's a sun, and I think there's a sea turtle over there right now on Dreamer Designs. So make sure that you check them out if you like Dean Russo. Like I said, I really wasn't sure if I would like this. I wasn't sure if it would be too confetti heavy. I wasn't sure if I would like it when I got finished. And hands down, one of my favorite kits this year, certainly, and probably one of my favorite kits so far that I have done for diamond painting. I'm trying to think if I have another kit that would beat it. I mean, other than Diana, this even beats my Mooka from Diamond Painting Shop for how much I liked it, and my Jules and Vern. Those are the ones I can think of that I've done recently. And, you know, I enjoy every kit that I do, but I just think this one turned out super well. And I won't lie, it could be also part of my joy in it is that I know that it's going to my daughter. I'm so happy with how it turned out, so she's going to get it. It's got a home, and somebody's going to enjoy it hanging on their wall. Okay. I am going to take a trip back into the regular studio so we can look at the trash, and maybe I will get this framed and I will insert a picture here at the end. So be right back. Okay guys, back here in the regular filming setup, and I got all of my drills emptied out. So I managed to get all of that done. I've got all my trays back in here so I can have this one ready to go for the next one. And here is all the trash. Now, it's not a huge amount of trash for as big as the kit was. So as you can see, most of them are like where they're doubled up and stuck together. Quite a few of the ABs were like that. And then I just had some that had tabs or weren't quite straight or, you know, were little pieces or whatever, but not a huge amount of trash. So happy with that. And like I said, super happy with the finish of it. This sticker I'm gonna cut down and this will go in my logbook, and I'm all kitted up and ready to go for the next one. I hope you guys enjoyed this lengthy video, so thanks for sticking around till the end. I hope it was interesting to see the kit go from kind of the unboxing the kit up, you know, I know you guys saw it in several whoopin' chats, and then to see the finish of it. Like I said, this has been one of my absolute favorite kits so far. If you can get your hands on it, I highly recommend it. I can't wait to see how it turns out. Once I get it in the frame, I've got a little bit of more work to do before I can put it in the frame. I will be probably posting pictures of it on my Instagram and in the Facebook group, so if you're not in either of those, make sure you check those out. I had so much fun doing DP for Pets this year. I hope you guys did too. I have so many cute pictures that have been coming my way as people fill out the exit form. I will link the exit form down below. Make sure that you fill that out along with your picture of your finished kit. And I will be working on the video montage of all of those finishes and doing the drawing for the final prize package winner. So make sure that you are subscribed, hit that subscribe button down below, hit that bell so that you'll be notified when that video comes out. That's it for me today, guys. And as always, thanks for watching.